It's amazing to have you with us at FrightFest. Few films have the impact that The Woman did. Can you talk a little bit about what motivated you to continue that story and what fans of the first film in particular can overall expect from Darlin?
Thank you. Oh, that's a big microphone. Cool, blimey, governor. So The Woman was a really important film for me and one that I respect and really love. It was actually Lucky McKee who suggested that I was asked to direct the sequel. So Andrew Vandenhout, the producer, came to me. And I wanted to write it because I wanted to make it personal. And Ketchum and I spoke about it, and he was excited for me to take it on. There are certain little kind of Easter eggs almost for The Woman fans. And this is a film that you can watch on your own if you haven't seen The Woman. You can watch this movie as a standalone sequel. But if you have seen The Woman, what's wonderful is that there are little moments, certain you'll notice the pink gloves, you'll notice a shot of a nun walking down the middle of the schoolroom like the teacher, Miss Ratone, did in The Woman. And you'll also have a better understanding of what Darlin grew up with when she was very young, and of course, The Woman and what she's capable of and what she's been through. So in this, she's a little more on the loose and wild and killing, rather than contained as she was in The Woman. So it was a lot of fun to play.
I think obviously the first film had a lot of very impactful, quite violent, quite controversial scenes. Can you talk a little bit about what fans can expect in terms of that element of this film?
Yeah, well, you know, it's... I'd say that the response I'm getting about Darlin compared to The Woman is that some people feel that it's less violent and less gory, but the kill count is actually higher, someone else was mentioning to me, and I thought, yeah, that's true. It's really a character study of Darlin through her experience of this world, and The Woman is not in the foreground as much as she was in the previous film. It was a controversial film, but I feel that it was a worthy film, The Woman. And in this case, you know, no one can really question that the Catholic Church hasn't been responsible for terrible abuses, and we all know this now. So I think it's a little bit easier for people to take that as sort of the bad guy, you know. I want people to take away their own, have their own experience with the film. I want it to be personal to them, so I don't kind of want to over-explain about what it's about. But I would say that friends who are not so into the gore and the scares felt that they could digest this one easier. I think because there's not so much extended suffering as there was in The Woman, and I think that's a little bit easier for people.
It's easier for people to watch, but it's a very challenging lead role. Can you talk a little bit about the astonishing young talent you found to take that on?
Oh, I'm so thrilled. I hope you'll be speaking to her in a moment, Lauren Canny. She is an incredible talent. She just turned 19 when we shot this movie. She's turning 21 later this year. And we were just so very lucky to have her. And she's, you know, Darlin had to be a redhead. She had to be the lead in the film. She had to be a great team player as an actor. She had to be confident and competent. And you had to fall in love with her. You had to believe she was entirely feral. You had to believe that the transformation she goes through. So when Lauren walked into that audition room and did such an incredible performance, I get emotional just thinking about it. I'm so proud of her. I think she's phenomenal.
Hi, my name is Lauren Canny, and I play Darlin in the film Darlin, directed by Pollyanna McIntosh.
It's amazing to have you here at FrightFest. Obviously, The Woman is a film that had a real impact on audiences. Can you talk a little bit about where this story picks up that legacy and what it was about this role that most excited you as a performer?
Well, yes, The Woman is amazing. So when I got this in, I went and watched The Woman and obviously fell in love. In The Woman, if you've seen it, Darlin is about 5 years of age, and you see her at the end of the film walking off with a woman into the wild, and this picks up about 12 years later. She's a teenager, she's been living in the wild for so long, and now she has become feral herself, and she gets taken in by a Catholic care home for girls where they try to civilize her. Very similar to The Woman, when they try to civilize her, it just doesn't go right. But this character is very nuanced. Pollyanna wrote a great script. It's a character that gets to be completely and utterly physical, animalistic, work on just natural instincts, which is something I don't do. I don't usually do a lot of physical stuff, so it was really nice to push myself to do that. But at the same time, she's still kind of stuck in that five-year-old headspace and is childish and naive and sensitive. So to get to play a role that has all of that was just an absolute treat. So as soon as I read that script, I said, this is something that I am terrified to do, but also would love to.
Talking about terrifying, obviously, I think the violence in the first film was much discussed and caused, I think, the majority of the discussion surrounding the film. Can you talk a little bit about that element of this sequel and how you think the violence and that side of the narrative compares to the first film?
I mean, it's a lot lighter, I think, in this film. I think what Pollyanna has tried to do is incorporate lots of different lightness and darkness parts of things. This is a coming of age story as well as a horror film. You know, there is a lot of violence and a lot of horror and a lot of terror in this, but also there's this really light comedy sort of coming of age aspect to it that really intrigued me, because I think life is just so not black and white, and the great thing about genre film and all film is that we can also, you know, have everything in one film. It doesn't have to be straightforward and linear in that way. So I loved what she did with it. But it's really interesting. I've never worked with a director who's also an actress. I had Pollyanna, who played the woman, and now I'm playing Darlin. So she has had she was a big influence as to how I try to teach myself to play that character. She is a really freeing director. She had such a great vision. She also, what was really important to me is that this was not going to be a film that just from the male gaze. This was a film that I didn't want to feel exploited in. That she spoke so highly that Darlin would not be exploited until maybe a certain point, and then it really punches you in the gut when that does happen. So I just felt really safe in her hands. She was so encouraging and just really freeing, and kind of let me do what I wanted to do as well, which was really lovely.
I think, I mean, on that note, obviously the horror genre, historically at least, has a bad reputation for how it treats women, both in front and behind the camera. Do you think that reputation has been deserved, and do you think it is in fact changing?
Do you know what? I'm not quite sure. It's my first genre film. What a joy. Like, it was an experience of a lifetime for me, because Pollyanna is so fantastic. But yeah, I think why I love this as well so much is because you don't really see a female anti-hero in this way. You know, it kind of, she's not great. She's a murderous, cannibal, feral girl. But you also want to root for her from start to finish, I hope. I hope audiences do love her and do root for her. So I don't see that very often in horror, that you can get this central role. Most of the roles are women. That you root for, that are anti-heroes, which was really, really nice. I hope it's changing. I think it probably is. I think it's about time. So fingers crossed.
Of course, you mentioned genre cinema. We're here at FrightFest celebrating the horror genre. Can you articulate for you what you think the magic of horror is, what both audiences and the storyteller get from it they perhaps don't from other forms of cinema?
I think it's a complete and utter release. It's otherworldly. What I love about it is that the stakes are so high that you, from you know, the get-go, hopefully you're engrossed in something and you just kind of forget everything else, because you can't look away with horror film. You know, there's almost no moments of relaxation. You're always kind of waiting for the next thing, the next jump, the next kill, which is what I love. Just this massive high stakes.
When you're getting into that zone as being a feral cannibal murderess, where are you looking for that?
I did lots of weird things. I mean, Pollyanna gave me lots of documentaries to watch. There are cases of young girls who've been trapped away and are kind of feral-esque, who don't speak and who learn to speak and how they act. I also watched random videos of animals in the wild, how they move. But when it came to it and we actually got to Baton Rouge to film, I kind of just wanted to go off instinct. I'd spend a lot of times before scenes in like the corner of a room somewhere dark, just on all fours, growling and doing crazy stuff. And we had a day, I remember, with lots of extras, and they were just like, what is she doing? Because I was just in the corner by myself making noises and crawling and trying to get it as much into me as I can before I go onto a screen, and then I can let it go and just let it be free, which was lovely.
You mentioned extras there. There's obviously quite a few familiar faces alongside you in the cast. Can you talk about your experience working alongside the rest of this ensemble and some of the great faces we'll recognise instantly?
Well, I mean, the cast is absolutely bloody brilliant. We've got Brian Batt, who's just, he was in Mad Men. He's a fantastic actor, which was a treat for me, because it's our relationship in the film is a tricky one. It's a sensitive one. we have some scenes that I was afraid to do with another actor who didn't care as much and who wasn't as great and who wasn't as lovely and kind and giving. It could have been a lot harder. So thank God for him. He was incredible. We had Nora Jane Noon, who's an Irish actress. She was in the Magdalen Sisters, so I've been a fan of her forever, since the first time I saw her. She was absolutely incredible, and because she was Irish and I'm Irish, I felt like I had a sister there with me the entire time. And this had a lot of darkness in it, so to have her, and then Cooper Andrews, who's in The Walking Dead as well, he was just the loveliest and funniest and a great talent. It was just a beautiful time. And then we had all those girls in the home, so to have loads of girls my age to hang around with, it was just something that could have been maybe harder was made so much lighter by a great ensemble and an incredible crew. It's great.
And my very final question, what does it mean for you to be a part of FrightFest?
Oh, it's just brilliant. I've never been here before, so I'm absolutely honoured to be here. It's a 20-year anniversary, so it's incredible. It's just, and it's just great to bring Darlin to a festival for this type of film, for people who really appreciate gore and horror and genre film. It's just, I hope I get to be here again.